好，欢迎收看《金秒志》，我是 Amanda，
我是 Chris。这算是我们第一次搭档吧？
是。
对，那我们今天人在表达剧台要来看的是
《匠心独具时间艺术展》。
今年非常精彩。今年呢，我们邀请了14个不同的品牌，然后也有从来没有来参加过 IWC 的品牌。也有全新才刚成立没多久很厉害的一个品牌，那今年呢，这些品牌总共带来了超过100支的作品，然后价值超过6亿台币，所以非常的精彩。其实我一直觉得制表是一种艺术，那为什么要叫做时间艺术展？我觉得这是我们想要传达的一个讯息。那其实现在要看时间，很多方法都可以看得到，而且比看手表还便利。那我觉得其实制表的这个工艺呢，我们除了把它当，我们已经改变了以前实际的一个看法，我觉得它现在就是一门艺术。那我们办这个展最大的目的呢，就是希望就是除了主流品牌之外呢，各个消费大众呢也能够用不同的眼光来欣赏这一些不同的艺术作品。
其实呢，这一次的 IWST 它是历届来规模最大，然后展品最多，金额也最高的一届。那其实独立制表品牌呢，其实对我来讲，其实除了表款的工艺性非常的有赏玩价值之外，我觉得其实他们独立制表品牌彼此之间那种没有竞争关系，然后很像一个联盟，大家都是朋友之间，互相鼓励，互相合作，然后可以进行一些技术的交流。我觉得这种很友谊的互动，其实也是我对独立制表就是我觉得蛮欣赏的一个原因。
我觉得这是有一些新加入品牌，我觉得还蛮有趣的，像是我们稍早的时候有专访到的 CP 这个品牌就很有趣，因为它大概是在2010年前后的时候诞生的品牌，其实不算太长。那专注在陀飞轮，专注在多轴陀飞轮，而这两个东西其实都有人做，也不算是说很少数，但他们自己做起来就有他们自己一道诠释的方式，然后再加上它有一些独到的技术，我觉得这也是这次蛮有看头的一个品牌。
We're a very small brand. We only produce 50 watches a year. So our watches are targeted for collectors. We've been now for the last 14 years making watches. I called the brand Cecil Purnell after my grandfather, who was a watchmaker. I started this because he always explained to me that the most complicated and best movement was a tourbillon. We've only made tourbillons since we began.We're right now on our 13th example of movements. So we are somebody who makes bespoke watches, you know, for collectors. We're very interested in the market in Asia, because Asia has probably one of the largest importance in the watch industry for collectors. Not just, you know, mass market products. You have people who understand watches extremely well, who follow watches probably closer than anybody. The Asians are very interested in details. So we started this brand, we've built up a loyal clientele of customers around the world who look for innovation and what we can do next. We wanted to be recognized more for what's inside of the watch. And we wanted to giveThe pleasure of visual aspect to the client, so that when they wear the watch, not only can they see like the barrels, not only can they see the power reserve, they can see the full movement. So person who sees the watch, okay, has the ability to say, oh, that's something unique you're wearing. What brand is it?
加入的新品牌呢，除了刚刚说的 CP 之外，还有另外一个品牌是 Antoine。
This is our last model. It's the triple tourbillon. It's a very complicated watch, and the most difficult is to adjust the triple tourbillon one by one, and each tourbillon turn in 60 seconds. and all three tourbillon turn around the die in 10 minutes. And this watch is in white gold with the beautiful diamond, with 24 carat of diamond, yeah.We are real watchmaker, and I explain that to the client. And we are father and son. This is very beautiful story, you know. The client want to know, are you watchmaker? And they come, you know, with confidence. Tell you, we stop the time and we are inside the watch. We fly inside the watch and the movement, yeah? And the time go very fast.My wife, sometimes she called me, the food is ready. okay, I will come. But you see, the time go fast, but I stop the time on the same time because we enjoy and we love our job. Yeah.
刚讲的这两个新来的品牌，其实我们如果回来看绕了一圈，这么多的品牌，这么多牌子，你自己有没有什么一些亮点、印象深刻的牌子？
印象深刻的牌子，其实印象深刻的牌子蛮多的，不过因为手表真的每一只都蛮炫的嘛。那如果我是讲到钟呢，其实那个 La Pei 这个它也是第一次参加 IWST 的牌子。我觉得它今年的那个以古董赛车为灵感的那款钟，其实我觉得就印象蛮深刻的，因为它算是跟瑞士艺术设计学校合作的一个作品。然后它的上链方式呢，就很像我们小时候在玩的那种发条小汽车，就是你把它稍微往后拉，就是等于在帮它上链。那它这一款也是一样的概念，就是把它轮胎往后拉，就是帮它上链，然后它调时间呢，就是在它方向盘的地方。我觉得它真的有一种好像把小男孩的玩具，然后升级为大男孩的梦想那种感觉。我觉得这种传承的概念，就是好像也是蛮符合独立制表的精神。
不过，如果真的，我们这样讲好了，如果我们真的要选一只，你自己要带回去，就无偿让你带回去，
是，
你自己会选哪一款？
好，如果真的无条件要选一款呢，我觉得我会选 MBAF 的 Flying T。嗯哼，虽然我个人不是很喜欢典型的女表，也没有觉得女表就一定要镶钻啊，一定要做的好像很给女生戴的那种样子。可是因为其实，在听完 Max 在讲他设计 Flying T 的一些构想之后，我觉得真的好像有被他打中的感觉。我觉得手表这种东西，除了它工艺以外，我觉得它的设计发想其实也是很打动人心的一个点。
For 14 years, I've been creating at MBNF only watches creations for who? Myself. And so, for the first time, I realized about 4 years ago that my whole family at that moment was my mother, my wife, and my daughter. My mom unfortunately passed away, and I had a second daughter. So for the last 6 years,my family is three women. And so I thought, try and do something for them. For once, don't do it for you. But doing something for somebody else is already something I don't know how to do anymore. But doing it for a woman and women I love, that's like the ultimate challenge. And especially as we men, we have no idea what women want. I was completely blocked. I was blocked. I didn't know what to do. And thenI deblocked the day I realized, do what you love doing, which is kinetic sculptures, and try and embody everything you love in your wife, everything you loved in your mother, everything you love in your daughters. And that's what I tried to do with the Flying T. I tried to do something which was crazy and at the same time super elegant, which is very difficult. I call it the Flying T, and everybody thinks it's because it's a flying tourbillon, but my wife's name is Tiffany.So there you go, I've never said that before. So there you go.
我如果真的要选的话，有点纠结，因为很多款都很喜欢。那真的要比的话，有一款 CP 那一款的双多轴陀飞轮，那一款我自己个人很爱，我真的还蛮喜欢，因为很轻，然后又 它那个结构视觉效果很棒。另外一款的话，当然就是我们讲说独立制表里面的圣杯，Gravel Fossé。
This is at the more complicated end of Gravel Fossé work. So combining the beautiful asymmetry of the case that we see here with our quadruple tourbillon system, very unique tourbillon 1 and 2, tourbillon 3 and 4, driven from a differential system from one energy source, all carefully concealed under the dial, and then leaving a beautiful space here to have three-dimensional rotating globe in real time there, with a view through the side window allowing us to see the equator and down to the southern hemisphere as well. So displaying daytime and nighttime. Then we have the GMT indication here with the pusher, changing hour by hour. The small second just underneath, completing that. And then the power reserve on the main dial of the local time, hours and minutes. I think this is one of the things for an independent watchmaker is to have your own idea, you have your own vision and own strategy, and so the possibilities are so wide that you don't need to copy something else or to take too much inspiration. You can find your own way.
其实我们前面讲那么多，我不知道大家会不会觉得好像独立制表是一个很复杂，或是好像要买手表买到一种程度的人才会接触到的东西。不过的确，我觉得它的工艺层面都是属于比较复杂的。可是其实，如果你要用艺术鉴赏的角度来欣赏它，或是你去了解一些它背后制表的精神，我觉得独立制表其实是蛮可以探讨的一门学科。我觉得，而且就不谈这些好了。我觉得你光跟那些制表师们聊天，然后看他们真的讲手表，讲到就是那种眼神闪闪发亮的样子，你都会觉得他们很认真在为自己的梦想努力。我觉得这种精神其实看了真的觉得蛮感动的。
好，我觉得说到底啊，其实消费者未来不管你喜不喜欢独立制表，我觉得消费者未来在选择的时候，其实不妨可以去尝试一下独立制表这一个类别，因为它就真的存在，而且它是一个很特别的存在在传统手表品牌之外，我觉得就有机会也可以去接触看看咯。那以上就是这次鏡表師為您制作的影音内容，我是 Chris，
我是 Amanda，
我们就下次见吧，拜拜。